Hi, my name is Kristen Jung. I'm going to be a future doctor, and this is my story. Welcome to Hawaii. I overcame so much adversity trying to do this video. Should I do it? Should I not? Should I do it? Should I not? And I had an exam last week and I got one tomorrow. But there was one voice that popped up into my head, and it was my dad's voice. And I heard him say, Kristen Jung, don't do anything half-hearted. If you're going to do something, you do it your best. Love you, Dad. And so here I am. What has my journey been like so far? Well, in my lifetime, I have been in pursuit of my purpose for a very long time. And I now realize that it has all led me to the most important decision of my life, deciding that I want to become a physician. To be a doctor is to improve human lives in a way that matters most, sometimes even in life or death, that will bring most fulfillment and meaning to myself and to others. My dad migrated to Australia from Hong Kong at the age of 16 years old, and he could have been a big hotshot in Hong Kong, probably like crazy rich Asians. And he gave it all up to be working class so that we can have a better and more stable future in Australia. My dad worked tireless hours at the family restaurant, struggling to get by, and my mum purposefully chose a part-time job rather than a higher paying full-time job, so she would be able to pick up my brother and I from school and also ensure that we get the best childhood as we can. It taught me a fundamental belief of family first above all. It couldn't have been easy for my parents to not let their financial problems get in the way of having the best education for me and my brother. Something that my grandpa always says to me every time I come and visit him at his house, 독서, 해독은 이것이. And that means education is the number one priority. I want to be able to give back to my family for everything that they have given me. And so my next chapter is to step out on my own and pursue my dream of becoming a physician. And I wanted to study in the US because it's always been a desire of mine to do that. And that is why, despite all of the odds on my journey, including all odds of traveling the international border during COVID to get here, it was really difficult for someone like me in my Chinese culture, where we're so closely tight-knit with our family, to leave them for a dream that I have.
You gotta understand something about me. When we had career day at school, I knew I wasn't smart enough to be a doctor. Not in my wildest dreams would I have ever imagined that I would ever choose this path. But along the way, I invested a lot in myself and my mindset, going to leadership conferences. I helped so many people to be able to overcome difficult situations and take control of their life. I felt so fulfilled meeting my innate need and heart for helping people and to serve where it really counts, that I realized I want to take what I was already doing to a whole new level. How I spend most of my day-to-days is pretty much almost studying 12 hours a day. And then any other moment in between, I'm working virtually with two different jobs and trying to juggle my school schedule and a different time zone. The other days, I'm interning at Maui Cardiology, who have successfully stayed open during COVID. It has taught me the value of community and really being there for Maui during a time of massive uncertainty. When I told Maui Cardiology about this grant that I'm applying for, you know what they did? This is a reason why I am there. They said they will donate some FIGS to the first responders here on Maui. How awesome is that? Something surprising about this path, I chose it because it scares me. Because it's not going to be easy. Because it's going to be extremely challenging. Because I don't think that I was ever smart enough to be able to do this. Because I believe that anything that scares the crap out of you is worth doing. And then you know that you are living up to your greatest potential. So I humbly ask that you please help me to fulfill my dream of becoming the first doctor in my family.